Hi guys, and welcome to another episode of Music in the Making. I'm Sammy from Campus Radio, say what you want to say. In collaboration with Patron's Day 2021, we have two very special guests here with us today. We first came to know about them through Project Superstar, and 2021 actually marks their 11th anniversary. Let us welcome the freshmen's Chen Diya and Carrie Yeo.
Hi!
Hi Sammy!
Hi.
Hi everyone!
We're happy to be here with you guys, and we would love to say what we want to say.
Well, I guess the first part of saying what you want to say is, what made both of you feel like a great team and decide to start the freshmen?
We are very, very different people. You know, the way we approach things, our thought process and things like that, sometimes can be very like clashing.
Yeah.
So I don't think we started out as a great team, but I think we started out with a commitment to wanting to be a team. Yes.
So as a team, right, how did y'all choose on the freshman as your group name?
It started with the Chinese name, actually. So we had a group of friends. We just threw it out to them and we said, can you help us to think of a name?
Mm.
But the only prerequisite we had was that
criteria.
It had to be three syllables, because only the three Chinese words bands are famous. So like you name it, usually it's like SHE lah, you know, like
Wu Yuetian
lah.
I mean, Fei Wen Hai.
Yeah. Three words, there's always a nice ring to it. So then, back then, they were actually a group of Mahjong kakis. They were trying out all the Mahjong terms like Pong Pong Hu la, Shi San Yao la.
It was really random, like someone said Cha Ban Sheng and we were like, In fact, actually, I didn't notice at first. Dia was, you noticed it first, picked up this nice name out of all the trash names they were giving us.
Yeah. And then she was like, for it very much.
Because
when we first started as Cha Ban Sheng as a freshman 11 years ago, we were far from being fresh. We wanted Cha Ban Sheng, the freshman, to embody was this spirit of like the freshness of the mind, freshness of, you know, the way we look at music and the world.
Yeah, actually, our name, the freshman, right, is the year, not the people, not the freshman, but rather the freshman year. So, you know, the first year that I remember when I entered university, I was so excited. It was 一个很多期待, you know, and but you're also kind of like scared, like you don't know what to expect. So that's the kind of like spirit that we want to carry on. Even if life, you don't know what's in store for you, what's in your future, you can still be very, very excited to learn new things and to explore.
It's your 11th year as a freshman in 2021, and you must have had some setbacks in the past 11 years. For example, you mentioned in an interview that you had an audience of one during one of your Taiwanese showcases. So how did the both of you overcome these setbacks and remain fresh?
We were like, you know, getting ready and like just waiting for the audience to come in, and then like there were none. And then we were like,
she was on the verge of tears. I was so she really, doesn't cry very easily.
Yeah, I was really like, I thought about like, I forget about it lah, like this one show. In fact, even that one audience is a friend. So, you know, it's like, hey, since you know, 你都听过我们这样多次, like since you've heard us, you know, in previous shows, how about like, let's just give up, you know, like, let's just not do this one show. Even though we only sold one ticket, this cafe owner took the extra step of giving us a token of appreciation. And in it, she actually wrote a note to say, don't give up. So even though this was a very painful memory, it was also a very beautiful memory in our journey as singers.
Mm.
So how do you think you glowed up from that setback?
I think ever since then, when we have interviews, right, Carrie will always say, it doesn't matter, even if there's an audience of one, like we will continue to sing.
I said it even before that show,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
And then
it was
really
a real
happened.
Test. It was a real test of what you said you would do.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Exactly. So I had to do the show.
I mean, I think you really glowed up, right? Since one of your songs, Shi Ai Ba Hali, was nominated for Star Awards. So in line with SMU's 21st birthday, what would you like to say to your 21-year-old selves? And for the audience who don't know, 21-year-old Dia was actually taking part in Project Superstar.
Maybe ditch the vest. Like, you know, get a different haircut. You know, to the 21-year-olds in SMU, you don't think so much lah. You just do lah. You know, at some point you're gonna connect the dots. And when you say connect the dots, it's a little bit like, you know, connecting the stars. So like, glow up, right? It's kind of like one candle lights another candle, one thing leads to another, one light to another light to another light. And then at the end of it, it becomes this
is wow, astrology.
What about Carrie?
For me.
Why your 21 self very far away?
You know, like 21, you're getting ready to step out into society, and I was quite blur. Like, I didn't really know exactly what I wanted to do. So I took the first job that I could. You know, like, I think don't compromise. It was a bad job. That's what I would say to the 21st year old you and me, to not compromise, be it in relationships or in terms of your career.
Okay, so what would you wish for the freshman on your 21st anniversary? So that's 10 years later.
Am I still alive? Strong knees and strong lungs, so that we can continue singing the crazy songs we have. I mean, we've been around for 11 years. Songs that we were singing 11 years ago, now when we sing, we're like...
like lazy. Yeah.
You know, like, I hope that the 21st year Cha Ban Sheng is very rich.
Oh, yeah.
It's very, very famous and rich, even though it will be so old. And that finally, like, Cha Ban Sheng can be our main source of income.
I think you dream on, lah.
But I hope that we will still be enjoying music, music making, music performing, and that we will still love each other, and that we would be happy.
Yeah. Hopefully at 21st, things will still be kept fresh.
Yes.
You know, for all you know, we'll be doing something completely different.
Yes! Maybe we'll be hosting and traveling around.
Oh, that would be nice.
Okay, speaking of doing something different, so we're very honored to have Cha Ban Sheng here as our very first Mandopop artist on campus radio. And we want to try out something new. We're going to try asking and answering the rest of the questions in Mandarin. Is that okay?
Okay, yeah, sure, no problem.
所以我们接下来的问题就以中文的方式来问答。 那Cha Ban Sheng其实参加过很多次的歌唱活动， 有没有哪一次的活动是让你们最难以忘怀的？
应该就是我们10周年的那场演出。
对， 2020年 是我们10周年， 然后我们其实本来有很多计划的， 我们想要脚踏实地， 我们想要去10个不同的地方表演， 然后第10个地方就回到新加坡， 然后是在 concert hall， 然后办一个1000多个人的演唱会， 哈哈啊啊， 然后 疫情就发生了， 然后我们所有的计划都打翻了， 然后结果泡汤了， 结果就是只能在室内， 然后做一个 live stream。
其实那时候我们都不知道会不会有机会做这样的一场演出，
对，
因为要做这样的一场演出， 其实需要计划的很多。 说实在的感谢主， 很多事情都蛮顺利的。 有了新歌， 然后新歌也让我们很期待跟大家发表， 然后也拿到NAC的一个补助金。 所以10月就能够办了一场演唱会。
对，
本来是计划说要唱1个半小时， 但是因为Cha Ban Sheng太会聊，
太啰嗦了，线上的演唱会变成2个小时。
然后就那种有感而发的开始跟大家分享很多背后的一些故事。 有机会的话希望大家能够 通过Cha Ban Sheng的YouTube能够观赏到这样的一次的live stream。
那你们比较喜欢的是线上的活动还是现场的活动？
当然是现场！
因为我们是人来疯， 一开始第一首歌通常我们都会比较战战兢兢。
我觉得很重要的是音乐一定要跟 观众有联系，
有connection。 对，
yeah， 因为我们在唱歌， 其实是在讲一个故事。 那我们也要看到你说故事或说笑话，你需要看到你的观众在笑或者在哭，所以哇，线上直播其实是有点辛苦的，对，
而且很想念那种 live performance。 有时候我们唱《放不下的活着》，在场的观众都会跟着我们一起唱副歌，每一次听到大家跟着我们一起唱副歌，我都会觉得。
很感动，音乐的魔力，每次都听到我很想哭，对，有时候就会觉得太棒了，不用唱了，哈哈哈哈。这么说，你们10年来推出的歌中，然后有很大一部分是你们自己作词作曲，有没有哪一个是你们最喜欢或者最有感触的？哇，我觉得每年现在每年都会换，对，其实在不同的阶段或者不同的天，a different day。 其实我都会有不一样的回答，因为好像之前我们是跟着张学友跑巡回的时候， 那时候真的最喜欢的歌是别走远了，因为真的很想家，然后真的在外面在国外走得很累，走得太远了，所以那时候最喜欢是别走远了，一边哭一边唱啊，听一边自己哭，而且白色自己写的 ，It's like oh my god， 他是唱出我们的心声，然后会那个时候很多人在国外的朋友也会 message 我们，会 DM 会私讯我们，就是说这首歌对他们来讲真的很有意义，然后他们每次想家会听。
对，但如果你现在问我们最有意义的是哪一首，应该就是静静，
就是新歌。就是疫情的时候很多人就是待在家，可能有些人觉得很孤单， 有一些人觉得很迷惘，或者是甚至有一点忧郁，就很希望这首歌静静可以陪伴着大家。
把音乐放出去最大的原因是希望它能够静静的陪伴着大家。它不是一个什么很华丽的一个东西，它就是很简单，音乐就是有它独特的一个魔力。然后希望插班生的音乐能够在过后的10年、20年继续的静静的陪伴着大家。
那我相信我们的观众朋友们都非常想知道插班生在11周年有什么计划呢？
虽然说10周年我们没有办法实行我们的演唱会的，算是一个梦想啦。
对，
在这第11年我们 会有一个演唱会。就在滨海艺术中心的 concert hall。
哎，这样的话我们可以顺便插播一下迪亚的 cafe Fantasy Coffee Bar is also at the Esplanade，
所以来看我们演唱会的朋友可以先来喝杯咖啡，然后来听演唱会。
对，
好，那我相信大家都非常的期待迪亚和 Carrie 在11周年的演唱会，但在这期间呢，大家可以在各大网站还有电台上收听插班生的10周年歌曲静静。And for our English viewers, you can catch the freshman's 10th anniversary song on various platforms and radios. Once again, thank you to Dia and Carrie for being here with us today.
Thank you, Sammy.
We're all very excited to see your concert in 2021. And this is Campus Radio. Say what you want to say.
Bye. Thank you, Sammy. Thank you, everyone. Thank you, Sammy.
Happy Patron's Day.